Hey everybody, and welcome to In 90 Seconds or Less TV. I'm here with fashion designer Sheldon Gray, everybody.
Hi.
So, first I just want to begin by starting off with, how did you decide that fashion was going to be your thing? How old were you? When was this your niche?
Ever since I was little, I really started playing with fashion and like reconstructing my own clothing at around 11, 12 years old. And I had a little sister and a cousin who are 3 months apart, and they were my muses when I was little. So all of their school dances, like I would make their outfits for them, I would get them styled and ready for school.
Nice.
So I always knew that I had a hand in formulating looks and coming up with, you know, culture through clothing. So that's pretty young.
That's really cool. So when did you decide to, you know, like kind of take it to the next level in terms of really making this your priority, fashion your thing?
Well, I went to Salem State College in Salem, Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm.
And I was there for business. And I did that for about 2 years. And it was cool, but then I was just like, you know, when I was in college there, I produced the first, like, a really good fashion show for them.
Right.
Like, me and my friends were known as, like, the mean girls. We used to, like, you know, dressed and, you know, in the cafeteria, and, you know, we styled each other. Like, we watched the Victoria's Secret fashion shows together. And then I decided to move on to fashion school. I went to the Art Institute of Fort Lauderdale.
Okay.
Where I studied fashion merchandising and marketing. And it was cool, but I just wasn't really that into that kind of structured school environment. So I was always a player in retail. I've been working in retail since I was 18, and I've been a manager in retail since I was 19 years old. And, you know, from then, I just kind of decided to make it my own and figure out how I'm going to make this business work for me.
Right.
Because it is a tough business, but it's only been a year ago since Clash by Dash has been, like, my baby.
Right.
And something where I decided to really portray my sense of style and how I envision fashion for my customers. But before that, I was doing brand representation too for, like, you know, new and upcoming designers and kind of like their PR person.
Yeah, well, that's really good. Because it seems like you're well versed. First of all, you definitely got the education to do your own thing.
Like, we're doing it everywhere.
Right, like business, fashion, not that, merchandising, manager.
PR.
Right, exactly. Yeah. But I really like your work.
Thank you.
How would you, for the people who haven't seen it yet, and we'll get to the point where they get to, you know, you tell them where to find all your stuff, but how would you describe your style of fashion that you create? What is Clash by Dash?
Clash by Dash is an essence of funk and rhythm. I am a huge fan of, I'm an 80s baby, so I am a huge fan of like middle 80s to end of 80s, like, you know, music, Lisa and the Cult Jam, Sheila E., and then early 90s swag, so, you know, all of, like, those, like, dope tunes I grew up on, like, my mother, my aunt, my godmother, have all played major parts in that, because I grew up to those tunes, and for me, that's how I make my clothing. All of my friends know, like, the more detailed my clothing is, it usually depends on what's in my ear or how I'm feeling that day.
Okay.
And also how much wine I'm drinking. But it just embodies creativity, and I just want to capture funk and, you know, beats through, like, my clothing, because it's fun, it's funky, it's eye-catching, it's different, it's one of a kind, and it's unique, because I really spend time and really think about how I'm going to portray, like, you know, the music through the clothing.
Right, definitely.
So,
no, that makes so much sense.
And I have, like, 20 projects all at one time, and I'm, like, touching it and doing this, and, you know, it's a weird process, but it works.
Well, do you ever, like, so now that you said you have, like, multiple things going on at once, do you ever, like, are you ever working on a piece, and while you're working on that one piece, you get an idea for something different, and you, like, kind of have to, like, stop, or what do? You write it down? Like, what's your process?
I kind of just keep it all locked in my head. I do stop, and I'll move on to the next one, like, right then and there, and do it, and then I'll go back to that piece, and then, you know, wait a little bit later, or think about it. Like, a lot of the times, I really get inspired by, like, the train system here in New York. and watching other people and like how they dress and, you know, their style, their personality. I'm really inspired by like, you know, graffiti and artwork on the walls.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's fun. And my clothing, I want children to, I really want to reach out to children because I want them to
right.
see that you can make anything your own and do it yourself and have fun with it. Like clothing, the fashion industry doesn't always have to be so cliche and,
right.
you know, Vogue and, you know, all of that, but you really can have fun with it and, you know, like it's pretty much like your soul.
Right, it's an expression.
Yeah.
You wearing yourself on the outside, basically
mm-hmm.
showing
exactly.
the world how you want to be portrayed.
Right, and like what you who you really are on the inside.
Right, that's
mm-hmm.
so true. That's why uniforms are the devil.
Exactly. But although I did want to go to a uniform school just because like those ties are cute.
So earlier you were talking a little bit about your mom and your aunt being kind of like inspirations for what you're creating now. Do you find that your family has been very supportive with you in terms of your fashion style, or like
yeah.
have they pushed you to be better, or like how are they? Because I know sometimes for artists, sometimes their families are like, you should really give up this art thing and, you know, just find a real job.
It's so funny. My family is so into it because I've been doing it for so long and they know that it's a piece of me. Like, there's like old clothing that they have. Like, my mom's always calling me, like, oh, your brother's jeans. I figured you can like clash them out. Or
right.
But they're very supportive. I've only been living in New York for a year.
Okay.
As a full time resident, you know, I lived in Boston, Massachusetts for all of my life. And it's so easy in Boston to kind of get ahead and to, you know, so it's so easy to be there and kind of, you know, ground yourself at a very early age. And here in New York, it's been so hard. It's just not even hard. It's just been a really different experience. Really, like, I really feel like this year I've really been on my own.
Right.
And really, like, getting in with the hustle and the bustle. And I'm a renegade. I believe in doing everything on foot.
Yep.
The power of, like, taking it back old school and really networking with people and figuring out how you can combine forces and really make stuff happen and really reach out to the public. But they have been 110% supportive. My godmother lives here in New York, and
okay.
she does pretty much a lot for me. And, you know, there is a lot of history and art in her background, you know, my family here
mm-hmm.
As well. So, you know, they're always giving me books and inviting me to art shows. Like,
yeah.
there's different things that they, you know, bring me to keep the art alive inside of me. They don't want it to die or to burn out.
That's very good. And I feel like that's very important just to have a kind of support system that can be there for you.
Yeah.
Which sometimes a lot of artists don't really have them.
Mm-hmm.
So then they have to fight another obstacle. It's like the family obstacle, which
right.
is like an obstacle no one ever wants to have to fight.
Mm-hmm.
But it's really good that you have that support system there. So in terms of fashion, are there any designers that inspire you, or where do you go to get some of your inspiration outside of the music that you listen to or that kind of drives Clash by Dash? What else inspires you?
I am heavily inspired by the Blondes.
Mm.
I love their work. It's very intricate. There's a lot of thought put into it. And they've kind of like mutated over the course of time from, you know, their first runway shows and now the stuff that they're creating. There's like a mechanism in which they just keep getting better and better.
Mm-hmm.
And just like Beyonce, I am a firm believer, like, you know, just wait and chill and don't be a third spot, as I say. And,
right.
you know, really put thought into like how you do it. And I think that they do a really good job at every season. They release something like phenomenal. It's one of a kind. It's custom.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something that not everybody can have.
Right.
Like, they want that person to feel like, you know, they have an exquisite piece. And they're like one of my biggest inspirations as far as like fashion goes.
That's really
because they started underground and they're getting real, like they're mainstream now. Like, you know, Beyonce's wearing them, J-Lo's wearing
right.
them, Rihanna's wearing them. Like, you know, everybody is wearing their pieces because of how much time they really take
to make
create their pieces. So,
that's
yeah.
really dope. So, what motivates you to continue to, you know, work on your own brand and being a better fashion designer out there and making your own statement here? Because I know you said, you know, in New York, it's way different than
mm-hmm.
when you're in Boston, because Boston is so small
yeah.
that it's just like, oh, you do that? Great.
Right.
Let's have a fashion show.
Right.
And it's
exactly.
like, next week. And that's all good. And it'll be great. You know, but that doesn't happen the same way here,
yeah.
at least not instantly.
Exactly. And that's, for me, what motivates me is I really am in the process of really creating a family of artists and a network for people to, you know, I'm all about like throwing events and fashion shows and linking people together and hanging out and having a good time where people really can fit in with each other
yeah.
and have good conversations and really kind of like bellow off of each other.
Yeah.
Because it just creates like a beautiful ambiance. And I think in the future, I want to, you know, create like a studio for artists to be able to come and use and, you know, work on their own work. And it just, you know, I, like Drake says, start from the bottom. I love like helping people like work together and
right.
to rise up together because it's hard, I mean, to do it all by yourself. So I would much rather work together and to make it happen rather than to, you know, have somebody struggle and do it on their own, especially if I know if I can be of some sort of help or assistance.
Right. No, definitely. And that's very important. Creating these bands of people,
Unit.
These teams of people
mm-hmm.
that will work together. And I think sometimes we forget that we can ask each other for some support,
right.
some help.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I know that you do this, then, you know, if someone needs that,
we
make it work.
Exactly.
Teamwork makes the
dream work. Exactly.
There you go. More
the best
thing
ever. Exactly.
So, thank you for coming and joining me today.
Me.
I really do appreciate it. But before I let you go, can you please tell the people where they can find you? Instagram, Twitter, Facebook,
yeah.
whatever.
My brand is at Clash by Dash on Instagram, Twitter, and my Tumblr is clashbydash.tumblr.com, and my Facebook page is Clash by Dash as well.
There you go. Now you know where to find them at.
And I'm also sold at Patricia Field in White Sea.
Yes. Forgot to mention that. That's a big one.
Yeah. And thanks to Barbie Beach.
All right. Thank you guys for joining us at 90 Seconds or Less TV. We'll see you next week. Bye. I can't wait.